In this video, I will be comparing Beehiiv versus Substack. So these are both tools that will help you start a newsletter or a blog. Now they both offer similar features, but they are quite different, and in this video I'll share the main differences between Beehiiv and Substack, and I will give you my opinion about which of these softwares is best for who. So first off, Beehiiv is the newsletter platform built for growth, at least so they claim. So the main thing that Beehiiv is for is to start a newsletter, and that's also its main feature. If you head over to features right here, you can see you can also launch a website and then send the newsletter. You can grow your list, monetize it, and repeat. So the main two features are basically the website and the newsletter. So the website is the home base for your content and readers, so you could start some kind of a blog, and the newsletter is for pleasing readers in the inbox one open at a time. Now let's take a look at Substack. So on the Substack website, it may look a little bit confusing because the Beehiiv website is strictly for actually creators, but on Substack you have both writers and readers, which you can see right here. You have the writers and the readers. So basically on Substack, Substack is also some kind of a marketplace with a mobile app where people can actually start reading. And you can see some of this right here. So you have, for example, a sports page right here, and they have subscriptions to kind of sports blogs or newsletters. So basically on Substack, you can start a newsletter and you can have people pay for it on the actual Substack platform. While with Beehiiv, you actually market somewhere else and not on the Beehiiv platform, and you just create a website and a newsletter. So the way that I would compare these two is basically if you want to use Substack, then you are actually creating your Substack, as they call it, for the people that are using Substack. So Substack is kind of a newsletter where people come to read all kinds of interesting articles with their paid subscription, basically. So how much does Substack cost? You have for readers and for writers. Now this video is specifically for writers. So you can see publishing is free on Substack no matter how many subscribers you have. If you enable paid subscriptions on your publications, the following fees will apply. You will pay 10% of each transaction. Now you can see that these people on Substack right here, for example, if I go to finance, this person right here called Doomberg has thousands of paid subscribers at a price of $300 per year. So let's say that thousands means 2,000, then you have 2,000 times $300. Now that comes out to $1.2 million per year from just this newsletter right here. Now if we click on it, you can see right here it has over 225,000 subscribers. So this is a huge newsletter. You can see it's the number one paid finance newsletter on Substack. Now with 225,000 subscribers paying $300 per year, this is an absolute goldmine for these people, and they are making a lot of money from this. So you can make a whole lot of money on Substack, but most of these people are not making that much. These are just the top ones. So if we click see who else is on Substack, you will see some more right here. So if I go to sports, for example, you can find a couple of examples. So it's basically kind of a news site. And for example, if I click on this one right here, you can see the newsletter here, and you get the option to subscribe. So you can see this person has thousands of subscribers, and if you click subscribe, you first need to enter your email, and you can see they have over 3,000 subscribers. And some of these newsletters are free, but also some of them will charge, for example, $10 per month. So if you're looking for a place where you can actually also get your email subscribers, and well, it's not really email, but where you can actually get your readers, then Substack may be better for you. But if you already have some kind of an email list and you have a way to collect emails, then I think Beehiiv is better for you. So now let's take a look at Beehiiv pricing. They have a free plan right here where you will get pretty much everything you need, but you get a maximum amount of subscribers. So the maximum here I think is less than 2,500. If you go over that, you can see the free plan is not available. So if you have more than 5,000 subscribers, it will be $79 per month when billed monthly, or you're 69 when billed yearly. So to give you an answer about whether you should probably be using Beehiiv or Substack, if you want to launch your own email list and own your own email list basically and own your contacts, then you want to use Beehiiv. But if you want to just use the Substack platform and use the readers that are already on Substack, then you want to go and use Substack. Now one warning that I want to give about Substack is it is pretty competitive, and it's quite hard to actually get a lot of subscribers on this since this is a pretty competitive space. However, you can definitely try it out and get success in this. So I'll leave links to both Beehiiv and Substack down in the description that you can use to get started for free with both of these tools. If this video was helpful, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel. With that being said, I will see you in the next video.